After covering 100+ features in iOS 26, I missed a few, so here's 10 more. From new ringtones available in the latest beta, options to control your iPhone with face gestures, background sounds like ocean and rain, wallet gets a feature I've wanted for a long time, and more. So let's get into it. First up, the latest betas in iOS 26 have new ringtones. And Public Beta 3 is also out if you wanted to try risking it on your main device. I have it on my iPad and my MacBook Air, but not my main iPhone just yet. But here in settings, let's go down to sounds and haptics, go down to ringtone, and just to compare, I have my iPhone running iOS 18.6 right here. And you'll see under this reflection heading, there's a bunch of new ones. I think one that goes pretty hard is this Dreamer. You also have Pond, which my flautist wife might enjoy. Pop. Surge. Surge is for that Tron sequel, and Buoyant. I do like these new sounds. I never have my ringer on, it's always on silent, but let me know down in the comments. Are you a silent mode always, or are you gonna use some of these new ringtones? Next, hidden under accessibility settings are new head gestures. So go to accessibility, scroll down, and then you'll see head tracking right here. Turn head tracking on. You might also want to turn off dwell control because that's gonna start taking action if you're just looking at a specific thing on screen. So toggle that off. And then you can actually customize different actions here, including open mouth, smile, raise eyebrows. And once you go into one of these actions, you have all these options here, like going home, opening the app switcher. I'll put the eyebrows as home, and I put the pucker lips right as scroll down. Now, once you turn on head tracking here, you do need to go back up to touch and then turn assistive touch on. That's gonna actually start tracking your facial movements, and you'll start seeing this warning that you have to bring your face into view. Now, if you think you'll be using these head tracking features periodically, but you don't want them on all the time, you can actually put in the control center, under motor accessibility, add the assistive touch feature. And now you can actually disable or enable assistive touch with all those head gestures right here from control center. So let's enable it. Now let's see if raising the eyebrows can send us home. Well, that worked pretty well. Like, let's go to Apple Podcast and scroll Primer Technology. That's my tech podcast, by the way. New episodes every Thursday. Subscribe up here. But I'm going to purse my lips to the right. That's pretty wild. And then you can customize other gestures to actually select and tap things on the screen. I'll raise my eyebrows again. And that brought me home. Number three, if you have a phone with Apple Intelligence, Visual Intelligence actually has a few upgrades. And remember, to access Visual Intelligence, it's just like taking a screenshot in iOS 26. Now, here in the screenshot view, you can do things like ask ChatGPT a question about what's on screen, but you can also circle and then do a reverse image search on what you circled. So I'm actually going to circle myself, and then you'll see down here, swipe up to see images from Google based on that search. So when I swipe up, I can see multiple results from Google and the different places that picture showed up. Let's try another one, like my picture here with MKBHD. I'll circle his face, and let's see what Google comes up with. Let's try that again. Maybe it'll get iJustine. Well, it got the pink right. Anyway, not only can you circle to search, but you can actually summarize either by taking picture of text or when you take a screenshot on a website like this, you'll also see a summarize button here at the bottom, and that's gonna give you a summary of the website you're looking at. Number four, if you have CarPlay, you know, anytime you might take a screenshot and you're in the car, you actually get a screenshot of the CarPlay screen in addition to your phone screen. Well, now I'm just gonna search for the setting, which I like the search bar is now at the bottom of settings. If you go to general screen capture here, you can actually turn off CarPlay screenshots. So now you won't get that extra screenshot of the CarPlay screen if you take a screenshot in the car. To go the long way, that's under general, and then go to screen capture, and you can disable it here. There's also a couple options here that I didn't cover before. One is full screen previews. So if you don't like that visual intelligence preview when you take a screenshot, you can disable that, and now when you take a screenshot, it's just gonna have the screenshot down here in the bottom left, like it did before Visual Intelligence. You can also choose automatic visual lookup, and that means when you take a screenshot, it's automatically gonna search for whatever's on screen. So now if I'm looking at something that Visual Intelligence can identify off the cuff, like an animal, it's actually gonna show that right here at the bottom of the Visual Intelligence screen, and this will include anything in the lookup feature, like plants, laundry tags, things like that. Number five, this might seem like a little thing for some, but I've been hoping for this for a long time. In the wallet app, when you add a credit card now, you can actually put in the physical card details, including things like the expiration date, the security code, and then that card info can be saved here in the wallet app. Now, obviously I use Apple Pay for a lot of things, but sometimes for online forms, I just need the card info. I used to save it in 1Password, and the iCloud Passwords app doesn't really have a good mechanism for that. But if I could save them in the Wallet app right here, I'm going to start doing that in iOS 26. All right, number six, if you use background sounds on your iPhone, like those ocean sounds or rain sounds, they actually got some big feature updates here in iOS 26. So under the accessibility settings, go down to audio and visual, and here you'll see background sounds. Go into background sounds, and I'm going to show you how you can add this to Control Center so it's easy to toggle on and off. But if you turn it on, it'll start playing the sound automatically. But you can choose your sound, and there are a few new sounds here in iOS 26, things like rain on roof. But two new features is an equalizer for the background sounds. So if you wanted to adjust the timbre of those sounds, you can actually adjust with this graphical EQ, choose a broad or focus style, and even balance it left and right. This equalizer is totally new, in addition to a timer for the background sounds. So you can choose to turn background sounds off at a specific time or after a certain amount of time of them playing. You can toggle the timer off and choose to always use these settings. Now, if you want quick access to background sounds, just swipe down to Control Center. You can start a new page or put it on that first page of controls. Add a control, and let's just search for background. Under Hearing Accessibility, you'll see the background sounds control here. And you can tap it, turn those on and off. And if you tap and hold on the control, you actually can change what the background sound is playing right here from Control Center. Number seven, you can finally get an alert on your iPhone when your AirPods battery is low. This will work for your AirPods Pro 2 or AirPods 4, but you can enable this in the AirPods settings and then get a notification when your AirPods case is low. Next, I talked about call notifications on Apple TV, and it said it was unavailable when I tried it first. That's because you have to enable it here on your iPhone. So I'm going to search for the phone app, and here in the phone app settings, you'll see calls on other devices. When you tap into that, there'll be a call notifications on Apple TV. Enable this for whatever Apple TVs you want to see those notifications, and now you'll see when a call is coming in. Number nine, you can now create folders in Apple Music from your iPhone. There's a bunch of other features here in Apple Music. I covered all of these in my 100 plus new features video. I'll link that above again and down in the description. But when you go to your library and into playlists, now when you tap the plus button here at the top, you'll see a create new folder option. Title the folder, and then you can put multiple playlists in that folder. All right, at number 10, this is a small thing, but a welcome change. If you wanted to navigate through menus and go back, you had to swipe all the way from the left edge of the screen. Well, in iOS 26, now you can swipe from the middle of the screen and keep going back. And honestly, it's a nice little change. Hopefully we'll make that more discoverable. So those were 10 more little hidden features in iOS 26, but get subscribed because as the full release comes out this fall, plus iPhone 17, it's gonna be a ton of videos, especially on shortcuts. And I got another video on that coming very soon. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments, hit that like button. I'll put my 100 plus iOS 26 features video right up here. And if you missed it, I actually built an iPhone app solely with ChatGPT 5. I have zero coding knowledge and never built an app like that before. And in just a few hours, I was able to vibe code an iPhone app. It was really just a proof of concept to see if it was possible, but I'm gonna be trying to do more complex apps very soon. So if you wanna watch my saga on doing that, you can check out the video right here. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you next time.